I just got the water jet all set up and cut out some test parts, and there's something I've been wanting to do for a long time now, just for fun, and that is cut a cell phone in half. And I know this is not the newest cell phone, this is like an S5, but again, I just got the machine set up and I'm doing some test cuts, and everything so far looks pretty good. You can see one of the test cuts I did right here, and this is quality at number 2 out of 5. I mean, look at those edges. That's just amazing what technology can do. And I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to slice it right down the middle of the camera. Maybe we'll even see the components inside the camera. I'm just gonna set the cell phone in place, clamp it down, and do a saw cut. Get a camera inside the water jet. I'm curious to see what it looks like inside the cell phone. Okay, now taking a really close look here, things get pretty interesting. Starting from the top to the bottom, we have the ear speaker, and you can see not only the magnet and the speaker diaphragm, but also the voice coil. And moving down to the camera, which is the most interesting part for me, you can count the elements. I mean, that's pretty crazy. And that last element there looks like it could be the image stabilizer. And if we take an even closer, more intricate look, if you see those 2 or 3 layers of copper with the channels running through, that's the actual camera sensor. And that's the rear camera there, which has stabilization on this model. And moving down a little further, we have our fingerprint sensor. Looking at the battery, which I didn't know there was a battery in the phone when I cut it. Not only can you see the battery contacts, you can see all the layers of the lithium ion still intact. And to see all the layers of lithium and membrane, and if you look at that real thin strip that goes across the entire length of the phone, that looks like it's the OLED screen that's underneath the glass. I just find this super intriguing, the way that they can fit all of these components in the cell phone this way. I mean, that's just amazing if you think about it. And then moving down all the way to the bottom of the phone, we have the loudspeaker, the home button, and it looks like the little vibrator for the phone, which is that little round thing there, I think. I'm not 100% sure. I hope you found that interesting, and if you're wondering why this isn't a warped perception episode, it's simply because it's not an iPhone 12. And it was a test, but if Lena's Tech Tips or Tech Racks or any of those guys wanna do a collaboration, I'm down. I know a lot of people are probably gonna say like, duh, it's a water jet, obviously it's gonna cut that. That's not what I'm really impressed by. I'm really impressed by the accurate precision, and I'm sure if I would've cut it a little bit slower, I'm pretty sure it would've been an even cleaner cut. So that kinda blew my mind, I'm not gonna lie. I was super impressed. That being said, tell me if there's anything you want to see cut with the water jet. I'm just as curious as you are to see how things work and see how the internal components are put together. I also find it really amazing how they're able to cram all those components so tightly together in the cell phone. That right there is kind of cool. I could only imagine like an iPhone 12 or a Samsung Galaxy S20 or something like that. So let me know what you think in the comments below. Hopefully you enjoyed that. Thanks for watching. See you in another video. Hopefully it's gonna be something cool.